Vive la Rock. We'll skip most of the intro and get right into it. All right, real easy intro here. So we have an open D to a G on the fifth fret of the D string, down to an F on the third fret of the G string, or D string, excuse me, and a slight bend on C to an A. You could play it with the D here. Oops. Not really sure which way Marco's playing it. Not really sure, but either way, real simple. And then we have going to the verse. Not a lot of pronounced guitar in the verse, but it's fine. Super simple, D, G, D, C, G, D. Now on the last G, it's played kind of weird. Not weird, but you gotta listen close. You hear how the band drops out and it's just the drums, and you hear you can hear it in there, listen again. So listen. So it's back there, okay? There's a G back there. The bass, I think, is playing a higher, octave higher there on that part. It's in there. One more time. Just a short little right in there. And then it repeats. Okay, let's go to the chorus. Chorus is super easy, it's just in C. Back to the verse. Okay, listen to this. Just the verse. Okay. Okay, so that instrumental part is just the verse, but on top of it, he's playing a. He's playing a part of like a G and a D chord. So you play a D to a G to an F sharp. Which kind of tells us that the verse is in G. Because of the F sharp in there. Listen to that again. Oops. Right. Might be hitting it twice. Let me listen to that again. Yeah, maybe so. Either way, that's what he's doing there. And then it just resumes normal service after that. Oh, some cool guitar coming here. Listen. So those chords are just a G and then a D, which are the same chords, just he's just pronouncing them. Yeah, higher G than usual, same D as normal. And that's really it. Another minute. He likes these long outros. All the way to the end here. So it sounds like it stops on the G. Okay, quick F in there. Yep. That's it. Great ending. Really great ending. So that's Vive le Rock, right on.